Hello everyone, Sundrak here. In today's video, I'll be showing you how to build the character Diona or Diona. Before we get started, I'm new to YouTube. If you like the content, please make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. Your subscription will help me a lot in growing my channel. So before we get started, the reason why I want to make a guide around now is that because the energy amplifier event, everyone have gotten at least one copy of Diona. And on top of that, she is one of the raid ups on Zhongli's banner. So if you were wishing for Zhongli, you probably got quite a few copies of her. So first we're going to compare her to Zhongli. What are the advantages and disadvantages since they're both consistent shielders in the game? Advantages is that Diona is of the cryo element, so she can cause more elemental reactions. Worst case, she can serve as a battery for cryo DPS for all current cryo main DPSs in the game, including Yuna, whose ultimate will cost 80 energy, so the energy recharge would take a while if you do not bring a second cryo character to charge up her ult. Second, cryo applications can be used in physical comp. Yuna won't need it because she is of the cryo element herself, but for builds like physical Kachin, physical Razor, you can definitely use Diona to constantly proc the superconduct. Her build burst is similar to Rosaria, where she applies the AoE range of cryo, and that can be used as a mount or freeze comp enabler. The fact that she can do more elemental reactions than Zhongli also means that she can support a lot of the meta comps involving Pyro, Hydro, and Cryo DPS, serving as a melt, a freeze, and a cryo battery. Her elemental skill is very good at popping Fatui Electro Shield, which is crucial for currently Abyss Floor 11 and 12. It can also temporarily remove debuffs of the Engulfing Storm, which is the Electro Elemental debuff that drains your energy. And last, she can also be very useful in the Abyss because if you pair her with a Sacrificial Bow, which can essentially reset her cooldown, she can basically ignore the effect of the slowing water in the Abyss, which is currently in floor 11. Now let's talk about some of the disadvantages of her over Zhongli. First of all, because she is all around support, she needs quite a bit of investment to be good. She needs a good weapon and she needs to have moderate to good rolls on her artifacts to show her potential, unlike Zhongli. Whereas for Zhongli, there are very different ways of building him, and even some of the worst artifacts can work on him. If you want to know how to build Zhongli, you can check out my Zhongli build, which is in my videos. Her ascension stats is also cryo damage, which is not very useful in a lot of cases as she would like to stack up on HP. Her shield is weaker compared to Zhongli's, and what makes it even worse is that Zhongli's shield can fortify. It can also apply debuff on nearby enemies. On top of that, since Zhongli is having a Geo shield, it has 100% absorption against all elements, whereas Diona's is a cryo shield, so it only has the 250 absorption rate against cryos only. But she is basically always used as a cryo enabler to pop cryo shields and stuff like that, so she's rarely used against cryo enemies, which means the 250 cryo absorption rate is almost never in use. She also has very limited ways to buff the entire team. Currently, the only two ways are either wearing the 4-piece Noblesse Oblige or her C6, which only buffs the entire team by 200 elemental mastery after she throws her burst. Compared to Zhongli's buff, Zhongli's shield can't debuff enemies at all times, and it is easy for him to keep up his shield. And last, Diona is rarely used for damage, so her damage is never something you can count on. So in conclusion, compared to Zhongli, Diona needs a lot more resource to shine, unless if you only want to use her as a cryo application support. In that case, she is as easy to build as Zhongli. Now let's talk a bit about her kit, her skills first. So her ulto is like any other bow user, and the charged ulto will be cryo damage. However, her ulto's damage multipliers is among the lowest in the archers, so it is not recommended to play Diona DPS unless you really like her. Her skill has two modes. If you tap it, it shoots out two cryo kitty claws. If you hold it, she backflips, and after she lands on the backflip, she shoots out 5 cryo kitty claws. It is important to know there is a delay between when you hold the E and when she shoots out the kitty claw. And if you happen to get trapped inside ice prison, which happens in the Abyss, she will take damage first, and then the shield will form around her after the kitty claw has been shot out. The shield will also only form if any of the claws hits a large obstacle, so like an enemy, a wall, or the ground. But that is not a problem most of the time, as it is guaranteed to pop in the abyss as long as you tap it. The shielding time is based on the amount of claws hit. It goes from 1.8 seconds to 2.4 seconds, which maxes out at her elemental skill level 7. So a few uncommon uses for her claw. First of all is if you don't have Ganyu, her claw is very good at killing birds and pigeons. You just tap her claw. As long as it's close enough, the claw will auto-target the pigeons. And it does not seem to have a vertical limit, so it will reach the bird before the bird can fly away. Her second usage is actually very specific. You can use it to find the location of the unusual helichrol, which is Wei. If Wei is standing on top of stone gate, and you shoot Diona's claw under the stone gate, the claw will fly straight up. If you know that, then you know Wei is directly on top of stone gate, so you don't have to climb the entire stone gate every single time to check if Wei is there or not. When her shield forms, weak cryo will be temporarily applied to her, and after a frame or so, it will disappear. Which means you can use this to remove the electro elemental debuff engulfing storm. However, because it is cryo, and according to the shield popping theories, you cannot use it to remove pyro or hydro debuff. And also, the nice thing about it applying cryo is that if Diona is wet and she applies her cryo to get the shield, she will not get frozen. So theoretically, Diona's shield is not much weaker than Xiangli's shield in terms of damage multiplier. And if you hold her shield, it actually also increases damage by 75%. However, as I said before, because of Xiangli's debuff and his more duration of the shield, it always seems that Diona's shield is somewhat weaker than Xiangli's. As for her burst, it is rather expensive, cost 80 energy, 20 seconds cooldown, only 12 seconds duration. Both the heal and the dealing damage is once every 2 seconds, so 6 ticks in total. Everything it applies is weak cryo, but however it does not remove the debuff on yourself like Bennett or Jean does. So if you have a C0 Diona, in order to pop off her burst constantly, you will need about 225% energy recharge, which is a huge requirement, assuming if you don't have a sacrificial bow to reduce the cooldown of your elemental skill for charging. And also regarding her burst, the heal is not as good as Bennett, even if you ignore the timer, which Bennett is 1 second per tick, Diona is 2 seconds per tick. And on top of that, Diona has double the Bennett's healing timer, which makes her not a very good healer compared to Bennett. As for her two passives, they are somewhat useful, but not exactly. So the first one decreases stamina if a shield is equipped. It also increases movement speed. The movement speed part is very useful if you're doing overworld exploration. And then the stamina consumption part can be paired with DPS that likes to use charge shots like Klee and Yanfei, and to an extent Kaching as well. Her second passive, when enemies are in her ultimate, their damage towards you are decreased by 10%. It is an okay one, it's not very useful, but it does boost the value of her ultimate by a bit. Her third passive is the same as Jean's and Barbara's, it has the chance to double food. As for the order you want to level up her talent, if you're building her support, no matter which support style you're building, you always want to go elemental skill first, then burst, and there's no need to level up auto unless you want to use her for DPS, which if you do, you have my respect. I'll briefly touch on her constellations. C1 is highly recommended to build her because C1 lowers the requirement of her energy recharge about 45%. So if you have about 175% energy recharge without a sacrificial bow, you will be able to constantly use her alt once the alt timer ends. Her C2, personally, I believe is the biggest spike in terms of her kit. It allows you to give shields to your teammates in co-op, even though it's only 50% of the time. It also increases shield strength, which allows more and more survivability. However, because of the fact that your teammates only get 50% of the shield that you're getting, so it is recommended if you play co-op to just tap her for high shield coverage on all teammates. Her C3 and C5 are leveling up the burst and the skill by 3 levels, so I'll not touch on that. Her C4 is not very useful unless you play her DPS, which I don't recommend again. However, the only one use is if you are using her to pop Electro Shields and you're already on cooldown with your Elemental Skill and Elemental Burst, then the 40% decrease timer will allow you to pop shields faster with her charge shots. Her C6 is nice to have, however it is 100% non-necessary, so there is no need to push her all the way to C6. In my personal opinion, C2 is enough to play her well. For her C6, whenever you are under her ult's range, if your HP is lower than 50%, it buffs your healing bonus by 30%. If your HP is higher than 50%, then you apply 200 elemental mastery on yourself. It allows her to buff the party in a bit, which is good. And on top of that, you play her alongside Sucrose. Sucrose can transfer another 40 extra elemental mastery onto the whole team. However, if you don't play Sucrose, Diana's C6 can actually work as a very good alternative building Sucrose, as it is also a good source of elemental mastery. And in nuke style comps, the added elemental mastery can use as a budget version of Mona if you do not have Mona and you would like to play her nuke style. As for artifacts, there are generally two ways of building her. One is as a healer focused, the other one is just to apply Quile. If you want to build her as a healer, the current best set is two-piece Maiden, two-piece Tenacity. It is chosen this way because she cannot utilize the four-piece Maiden, as her only healing comes from her ult, but two-piece Maiden is based on her skill. And she cannot use the 4-piece Tenacity well enough for it to be worth it. But for 2-piece Maiden, 2-piece Tenacity, Maiden buffs healing, and Tenacity buffs HP, and HP buffs healing and shield. So it is works well with her kit. It is highly recommended to not use 2-piece Bolide here, even though that has a 30% shield increase. However, it only increases her shield, not the shield of the character you swapped to, so 2-piece Bolide is not useful on her. If you're building her as a cryo application support, you can run 4-piece Noblesse Oblige. The 2-piece Noblesse Oblige is not very useful, and the 4-piece is just here so she can provide a team buff, and you can use her as a second character for your second team in the Abyss, whereas Bennett will be the other one holding the 4-piece Noblesse to provide buffs for your entire team. 4-piece Tenacity again is not recommended for her. It is too hard to keep up the 4-piece even with the sacrificial bow because you will still have that 6 seconds cooldown. As for artifact's main stats, you want to go energy recharge if you want to spam her ult, or if you have enough energy recharge, you want to go HP for your stand or hourglass. For your cup or goblet, you always want to go HP. Her damage is not very good, so you don't want to buff her cryo damage. As for the circlet or headpiece, you will want to go HP if you want to buff her shield, focus on her shield. If you want to focus on her healing, you want to go healing bonus. As for her weapon, I would only recommend the sacrificial bow. You can use it to fire double the amount of kitty claws for more damage, or you can wait until the first shield ends and then pop her second elemental skill to refresh the kitty claw shield. Vivonius Warbow, which you got for free from the Venti's quest, it is a good choice on her. However, it does not provide as much energy recharge as sacrificial bow, because sacrificial bow allows her to double her elemental skill. The way sacrificial bow is calculated is that each kitty claw is calculated separately from the previous, so especially if you're firing 5 kitty claws, it is very hard to not proc the passive. For 3 stars, the recurve bow is actually recommended for its HP substats. The passive is not very useful, and if you're considering putting the elegy for the end on her, it isn't since the passive has time restriction, it is not very useful on her. For her team comp, there are a few main ways to play Diona, mainly as a shielder, as a healer used in a pinch, as a cryo battery, as a cryo application character, or you play her for her damage buff. She can be used in melt comps with most fire DPS. However, the melt damage is not very good, because for melt you will want to proc from cryo side, not pyro side. But normally for her, you will apply the cryo first, and you would just switch your DPS to do the main damage, which then pyro procs cryo, which does not cause as much damage as pyro procing pyro. However, she is a good alternative to Xingqiu, because Xingqiu can only be on one team, so she can be an alternative to also proc the melt. In Xingqiu's case, he procs vaporize. She can be used in a double cryo comp as a cryo battery for the DPS, we've already talked about that before. And she can be also used as a cryo application character for physical comps, like for Razor and Kaching, she will just be there to apply the cryo to cause the superconduct. And if you have her as a C6, she can be used as a nuke setup team in place of Mona, or she can be used to buff the entire team after she throws her out. That is all the information I have for you today. Thank you very much for watching. If you like the content, please make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. Thank you and have a nice day.